Hello friends, I'm Maunika. Hope you all are good and safe. Welcome back to Learn HTML. Happy to see you all again in this HTML course. A warm welcome to you all. In today's video, we are going to discuss the concept of tables. In previous video, we discussed the concepts of list, right? In previous video, we discussed how to code nested list in HTML web page. We discussed the concepts of nested list and we discussed how to code that particular nested list in our HTML web page. And finally, we coded one exercise regarding list, which includes ordered list, unordered list, definition list, as well as nested list. These steps we discussed in previous video. So if you don't know these steps, or if you didn't watch my previous videos, I will provide links of my previous videos in description box. Kindly check over there. I request you to watch my previous videos, because if you watch my previous videos, you can get a better continuity over here. Okay, let's enter into today's content. Before entering into today's content, if you didn't subscribe my channel, kindly subscribe my channel and click the bell icon so that you will receive all notifications of my videos. Now, without further delay, let us proceed into today's content. This is what the agenda for today. As I said earlier, in today's video, we are going to discuss how to code tabular data in HTML web page. With the help of table tag, we are going to achieve this functionality. Hope you all know what is the meaning of tabular data. So there is no interior meaning. Tabular data, in the sense, there will be some rows and columns. This is what tabular data. Familiar example for tabular data is timetable or TV show schedules, etc. So these are what some examples for tabular data. So in today's video, we will be seeing how to code tabular data in HTML web page. This is what the main content for today. And after discussing these steps, we are going to discuss two more attributes, Rowspan and Colspan attributes. This is what the agenda for today. Okay, so we are having some bending steps in table. So that steps we will be discussing in next video. So after completing those steps, we will be discussing one exercise for this table topic. So in today's video, we are going to discuss the content alone. Okay, so first, let us discuss how to code tabular data in HTML web page. So for this, we will be using table tag. First, let me show some examples for tables, some examples for tabular data. So after that, I will explain how to code the particular tabular data in HTML web page. Okay, so first, let me show some examples for it. Okay, this is what example for tabular data. This is timetable, right? So in Monday, 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m., we are having max period. Similarly, for Tuesday, 11 a.m. to 12 p.m., we are having max period. Wednesday, 12 p.m. to 1 p.m., we are having general knowledge period. Thursday, 2 p.m. to 3 p.m., that is free period, or we can say leisure hour. Okay, so this is what the timetable. Okay, so this is one of the example for tabular data. Now let us discuss how to code this tabular data in HTML web page. As I said earlier, to code tabular data, we will be using table tag. Okay, so we need to code the entire content inside the table tag. We want to enclose it by table tag, opening and closing table tag. Okay, so now let me explain how to code this particular table in HTML web page. Okay, so for that, let me open text editor and web browser. As you all know, I'm using Sublime text editor. Okay, this is what our file, index.html, right? This is what our file, index.html. So let me open my web browser also. So this is what our file, index.html, right? So let me open this. Okay, so this is what our web page we have created in last few videos. Okay, now we can continue here. Okay, we can continue here. So what is today's concept? We are going to code this particular table in our HTML web page. So let me explain how to code this particular table in our HTML web page. Okay, so as I said earlier, with the help of table tag, which we can achieve this functionality. So let me open and close table tag first. Before that, let me code this heading, sample table. Okay, so you can use any heading tag according to size. So here I'm using H3 heading tag. Okay, H3 heading tag. Okay, let me close that particular heading tag. Okay, inside it, let me code that content, sample table, or we can code some other content. I'm coding here, sample table. Okay, so this is what heading tag. Okay, our system will understand this particular type of data is of heading type. This particular data is of heading type. Okay, now let me save it and let me show you in my browser. This is what index.html, right? So you can see, right? Sample table heading is displayed. Okay, now we coded this heading alone. Now we are in a position to code this particular table. Okay, I will explain how to code this particular table. Don't worry, coding table is very easy, don't worry. Okay, so observe this table carefully. Here, as you can see, we are having 7 columns and 6 rows, right? Observe my cursor carefully. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We are having 6 rows. Similarly, columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We are having 7 columns, right? So in this table consists of 6 rows and 7 columns. Okay. So first, let me open table tag. Okay. So as I said earlier, we are going to enclose the content in table tag. Okay. So let me open table tag. T-A-B-L-E. Okay. This is what table. As I said earlier, if a particular tag is opened, the particular tag should get closed, right? So let me close it over here. Okay. Between this, I'm going to code the content. Okay. So if a particular tag is opened, the particular tag should get closed. So between this, I'm going to code this content. Okay. If you want to code tabular data, you need to code within the table tag. Okay. If you want to code tabular data in HTML web page, you need to code within the table tag. Okay. So I'm going to code within the table tags. Okay. This is what the opening tag of table, because there is no forward slash. This is what the closing tag of table, because there is forward slash. Okay. Now I'm going to code the content. Okay. You can observe there are 6 rows, right? So I'm going to use TR tag. TR stands for table row. Okay. TR stands for table row. In this sample table, we are having 6 rows, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, right? So let me open and close 6 TR tags. TR stands for table row, okay? So TR stands for table row. So if a tag is opened, the particular tag should get closed, right? Okay, so let me copy this for 5 times. Because there are 6 rows, right? Okay, let me paste it over here. Okay. Okay, now I just created the TR tags. Okay, I just created the TR tags. Now, if you observe this table, you can see each and every row contains 7 columns. Okay, each and every row contains 7 columns. For example, you take first row. This is what the first row, right? So how many columns are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Similarly, you take second row. How many columns are there in second row? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Similarly, third row. Third row also contains 7 columns. Similarly, each and every row contains 7 columns, right? Each and every row contains 7 columns, right? Okay, so for each and every row, column, we will be calling it as cell, okay? So simply we can say each and every box is called as cell, okay? So for example, max, This max is enclosed in a particular shell. Computer science. This computer science is enclosed in a particular shell. Physics. This physics is enclosed in a particular shell. Okay. So technically we can say for each row we'll be having columns. Okay. For each row, each and every column we will be calling it a cell. See, this vertical stuffs are called as columns, right? Right. This vertical stuff we will be calling it as columns, right? So for each row we'll be having column, right? For first row, this blank cell is one column. This 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. is one column. I'm taking first row alone. So this blank cell is one column. 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. is another column. 9:45 a.m. to 10:45 a.m. is another column. So for each row, each and every column, we will be calling it as cell. Or simply, you please remind, each and every box, we will be calling it as cell. Okay. So we can say for each row, there are seven cells, right? For first row, there are seven cells. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Similarly, for second row, there are seven cells. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Similarly, each and every row contains seven cells, right? So each cell represents table data. Okay, each cell represents some data, right? For example, chemistry. Chemistry is data. What? Wednesday, 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. First period is chemistry. So this is what? Some data. So each and every cell represents some data, right? So what I'm going to do is that, as I said earlier, each and every row contains seven cells. Each cell represents data. I'm going to use TD tag. TD stands for table data. Okay, inside each row. Okay, because each row contains seven cells. Okay, seven cells. Each row contains seven cells. Each cell represents data. So inside each row, I'm going to quote TD tag. Okay, TD stands for table data. Okay, so let me code it. TD stands for table data. If a tag is open, that particular tag needs to be closed. Let me close it over here. So I need to code it for seven times because each row contains seven cells, right? So let me copy this. Let me paste it over here. Let me code it for seven times. Okay, now I coded for first row. Okay, see, now first row contains seven cells, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Similarly, each and every row contains seven cells, right? So let me code for other rows also. Here I coded for first row alone. We have created six TR tags, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Why? Because we are having six rows and each and every rows contain seven cells. So we need to code that particular information for each and every row. So let me copy this and let me paste it for each and every row. Okay, before the closing tag, you need to paste it because each and every row contains seven columns or seven cells. Okay, so before the closing tag of TR, we need to code that content. Okay. Okay. So hope you can understand this code. Okay. Now let me explain. Okay. Now see here. Wait. Now here, this is what first row, right? This is what first row. So here, as you see, first row, in first row, first cell is blank, right? In first row, first cell is blank, right? So you here, we don't want to code anything. Okay, here, first cell is blank. So this content can be empty. Okay, here there is no content. So we don't want to code anything. Okay, similarly, next cell. Okay, in first row, this is what first row, right? So in first row, first cell is empty. So there is no content. I'm leaving it as empty. So second cell, what I'm having? 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. So let me code it over here. 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. Okay, next. You just concentrate on first row alone, because this row is dedicated to first one. Okay, first row. Okay, this TR tag is dedicated to first row. Okay, next. In third cell, what we are having? 9:45 a.m. to 10:45 a.m. Right. So let me code it over here. 9:45 a.m. to 10:45 a.m. In fourth cell, what we are having? 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Right. So let me code it over here. 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Okay. See, in fifth cell, what we are having? 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. So let me code it here. 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. In sixth cell, we are having 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. So let me code it over here. 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. Okay. Final cell, we are having 3:15 p.m. to 4:15 p.m. So let me code it here. 3:15 p.m. to 4:15 p.m. Okay, now let me save it. Control S. Now let me show you in my web browser. See this content displayed. Yes, this is not in tabular format. Let me explain. Okay, so now we code at this content alone. Okay, this first row alone. Now we are going to code second, third, fourth, fifth, and final row. First, let me code this Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Okay, so for that, I'm opening my text editor. So in second row, first cell is dedicated to Monday, right? So this is my second row. First row is completed. This is my second row. So first cell is dedicated to Monday. So let me code Monday over here. Okay, in third row, first cell is dedicated to Tuesday. So in third row, I'm coding first cell. This is second row and this is third row, right? So I'm coding Tuesday here. In fourth row, this cell is dedicated to Wednesday, right? First cell is dedicated to Wednesday. So in fourth row, in first cell, I'm coding Wednesday. Okay, so in fifth row, first cell is dedicated to Thursday. So in fifth row, this is what my fifth row, right? Fourth row, we have coded Wednesday. This is what my fifth row. So in fifth row, first cell is dedicated to Thursday. So let me code Thursday over here. Okay. Final row, first cell is dedicated to Friday. So let me code Friday over here. Okay. Now let me save this and show you in my web browser. Control S. See, you can see it, right? Now we code at this heading and this heading. 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. 9:45 a.m. to 10:45 a.m. till 3:15 p.m. to 4:15 p.m. We coded this thing also. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So this content is displayed now. Now we are going to code inside information like periods, max, computer science, physics, technical skills. Okay. So now let me code max hour first. Okay. See, max hour is in Monday, we are having first period as max. That means in second row, second shell is dedicated to max. So let me take second row. So this is what my second row, right? Monday is first shell. So second shell is dedicated to max, right? So let me code max over here. Okay. Then where is max? In third row, fourth cell is dedicated to max. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? In third row, fourth cell is dedicated to max. So let me copy this max here. So in third row, Tuesday is third row, right? Fourth cell is dedicated to max. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So let me paste it over here. Okay, next, where is max? In fourth row, last shell is dedicated to max. So this is what my fourth row. In last shell, I'm going to paste max. Okay. Similarly, in fifth row, there is no max hour because Thursday there is no max period. Okay. So Friday, third shell is dedicated to max, right? In final row, third shell is dedicated to Max. So Thursday, there is no Max ever. So in Friday, third shell is dedicated to Max. 1, 2, 3. So let me code Max. Now, let me save this. Control S. So let me show you in my web browser. Reload it. You can see Max. Okay. So far, we coded Max data. Similarly, we need to code other data also. Let me code it for computer science. Okay. So computer science. For computer science, in second row, third shell is allocated to computer science, right? So let me take second row. This Monday is of second row, right? So in first shell, we are coding Monday. So in second row, third shell is allocated to computer science. So third shell, 1, 2, 3. This is what third shell, right? So let me type computer science over here. Okay, now let me paste it, copy it, and let me paste wherever the computer science is needed. Okay, now let me copy it. Okay, now see, now Tuesday. Okay, in third row, sixth shell is dedicated to computer science, right? So I am taking third row. This is my sixth shell. I am pasting here. Okay, similarly, in fourth row, that means Wednesday. In Wednesday, fourth shell is dedicated to computer science. So in fourth row, fourth shell is dedicated to computer science. Similarly, in fifth row, third shell is dedicated to computer science, right? So Thursday, third shell is dedicated to computer science. Similarly, final shell is dedicated to computer science. So final row, final shell is dedicated to computer science. Now let me save this information, control S. Let me show you in my browser. Now I coded computer science information also. So far we coded two subjects, Max and computer science. Okay, next we can code it for physics. Okay, so let me open my browser. Let me open my text editor. Okay, so Monday, okay, in second row, fourth shell is dedicated to physics, right? So this is my second row, Monday. This is my second row. Here, fourth shell is dedicated to physics. Let me code physics here. Physics. Okay. Now, let me copy this physics. Okay. Okay. Next, in third row, fifth shell is dedicated to physics, right? So third row, this is what third row, fifth shell is dedicated to physics. Okay, next, in fourth row, first ever is physics. That means second shell is dedicated to physics, right? So here I'm going to paste physics. Okay, similarly, Friday there is no physics ever, so no need to paste it. Okay, no need to paste it. So, see, in third row, so, okay, in fourth row, this sixth shell is dedicated to physics, okay? So, in fourth row, this is what fourth row, right? Sixth shell is dedicated to physics. Let me paste it, control S. Let me show you in my browser. Now, we successfully coded physics also, okay? Still, we have technical skills, general knowledge, and chemistry. So let me code technical skills, okay? So technical skills. So technical skills, in second row, sixth shell is dedicated to technical skills, right? So this is my second row. Sixth shell is this one. So I'm going to code technical skills over here. Technical skills, okay? Next, in third row, second shell is dedicated to technical skills, right? So let me copy this first. In second row, okay, in third row, second shell is dedicated to technical skills. So this is third row, second shell is dedicated to technical skills, right? So let me paste it over here. Okay, next. In fourth row, there is no technical skills period. Okay, next. In fifth row, fourth shell is dedicated to or allocated to technical skills, right? So in fifth row, okay, in fifth row, fourth shell is allocated to technical skills. Similarly, in final row, fifth shell is allocated to technical skills, right? So in final row, fifth shell is allocated to technical skills. So let me paste it over here. Okay, now Control S. Let me reload my browser. You can see computer science and technical skills, maths and physics period. Okay, these four periods are available now. Okay, we have coded these four periods. Next, still general knowledge and chemistry are pending. Let me code for those two periods also. First, general knowledge. Okay, so general knowledge, second row, last shell is allocated to general knowledge. So let me code it over here. Okay, general knowledge. Now let me copy it, Control C. Okay, then I'm going to paste wherever I need this particular data. See, in Tuesday there is no general knowledge period. Wednesday I have 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. general knowledge period. That means fourth row, fifth shell is dedicated to general knowledge, right? So fourth row, fifth shell is dedicated to general knowledge. Okay, next, fifth row, last shell is dedicated to general knowledge. So fifth row, last shell is dedicated to general knowledge. Okay, next, final row, second shell is dedicated to general knowledge. Final row, second shell is dedicated to general knowledge. So let me save this, Control S. Let me show you in my web browser. See, general knowledge is also included. One more subject is pending, chemistry. Let me code chemistry also. Okay, so in second row there is no chemistry. Okay, in third row, that third shell is allocated to code chemistry. Okay, third shell is allocated to chemistry. So third shell is allocated to chemistry, right? So let me code chemistry. Okay, now let me copy this, Control C. Okay, now in fourth row, okay, in fourth row, second shell is allocated to chemistry, right? So this is what, fourth row, Wednesday. Okay, second shell is allocated to chemistry. Let me paste it over here. Okay, in fifth row, fifth shell is allocated to chemistry, right? So in fifth row, Thursday, right? In fifth row, fifth shell is allocated to chemistry. So let me paste it over here. Okay, next, Friday, that means in final row, sixth shell is allocated to chemistry. So in final row, sixth shell is allocated to chemistry. Let me paste it over here. Now let me save this, Control S, and let me show you in my browser. You can see it, right? You can see, except this lines or except this border, you can see this table. This is how you need to code the table. Okay, this is how you need to code the table. Okay, now what I need to say is that how to code this border. Okay, if you want border, what we need to do? If you want border, you need to specify border attribute. Okay, so let me show you. Okay, so in table, this is what the opening tag of table, right? So I'm going to specify border attribute over here. Okay, border is the name of the attribute. Border is the name of the attribute. You can specify any value. If I specify one, what will happen? Control S. Let me show you now. Let me reload it. You can see the border. But border is very thin. If you want the border to be thick, you can specify some large value, 10. Now you can see. Border is thick, right? So according to the border thickness, you can specify any value. Okay, if you want the border to be thick, you can specify large value. If you want the border to be thin, you can specify small value. I'm specifying some intermediate value. Okay. Now, control S. So this is what the border. So this is what the table. Likewise, we need to code the table in our HTML web page. And one more thing I want to say is, see, here, as I said, each cell represents data, right? But here, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, these five things are not data. Similarly, 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m., 9:45 a.m. to 10:45 a.m., these timings and these days are not data. These timings and these days are heading. Okay, so see, in Monday, 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m., I have max period. So max is the data. Okay, similarly, in Thursday, 12 p.m. to 1 p.m., I have chemistry period. So this is what the data. Okay, here, this days and timings are heading. Okay, so using TD tag to code, this is inappropriate. Okay, physical appearance may be same. Okay, but you need to use the appropriate tag. Okay, so these days and these timings are not data. These things are heading, right? So instead of TD tag or instead of table data tag, you need to use TH tag. TH stands for table heading. Okay, so instead of TD tag, you need to use TH tag. TH stands for table heading. So let me change this. Okay. See, these things are heading, right? So 8:45 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. timings are heading, right? So instead of TD tag, you need to use TH tag. So let me code like this. TH stands for table heading. Okay, table heading. So let me do it for all timings. Let me copy this thing. Opening tag of this. Okay, let me paste it over here. Similarly, let me do it for all things. Okay, now let me do it for closing tag also. Okay, if a particular tag is open, that particular tag needs to close, needs to get closed, right? Similarly, let me do this. Here also, okay. Now let me save it, control S. Let me show you in my browser. You can see these timings are in bold, right? These timings are in dark color. Similarly, let me do it for these days also. Okay, Monday. So Monday is heading. So instead of TD tag, let me use TH tag. This is what the appropriate tag to code this. Similarly for Tuesday. Similarly for Wednesday. Similarly for Thursday. Similarly for Friday. Now let me save this, control S. Okay. Let me show you in my browser. You can see this, right? So this is what the table displayed here. We coded the same table in our HTML web page. So this is what the procedure to code table in our HTML web page. Okay. See, you need to remember one point. Okay. If you want to code tables, that entire content should be enclosed in table tag. Here I'm opening table tag, right? Here I'm closing this particular table tag. Okay, if you want to code such table, you need to enclose this using table tag. Why? Because this table tag tells our computer, or we can say table tag instructs our system to treat this content, to treat this entire content is of table tag. Okay, so by seeing this table tag, our system will understand user is coding some table. User wants to display table in web browser. Okay, our system will understand. Okay, so entire content should be wrapped within table tags, opening and closing tag of tables. Okay, so this is how you need to code the table. So this is what the simple table. Okay, so this is what the simple table. Okay, so we coded this table in our HTML web page. This is how you need to code it. Okay, now let me explain how to code this type of table. See, this table is the basic here. This is how you need to code basic tables. This is what the basic table coding. So if you want to code this type of tables, you need to do some modifications in it. That's it. Nothing difficult here. Okay, if you understand or if you know to code this basic tables, you can code this type of table also. Okay, now if you code this type of tables, you can modify something and you can code like this. Now let me explain how to code this type of tables by modifying some content. I'm going to modify my source code. Okay, I'm going to modify my source code. Okay, by modifying my source code, I'm going to code this type of table. Okay, now we coded this table. Okay, this first table we coded here in our HTML web page, right? Now we are going to change this table like this new table. Okay, we are going to modify this table like this. Okay, we are going to modify this table like this. So for that, we will be using these two attributes, Rowspan and Colspan attributes. So far we discussed these two stuffs, how to code tabular data in HTML web page, and we discussed uses of table tag. Okay, I said what is the main purpose of table tag. Table tag is used to code tabular data in HTML web page. So now to code this type of tables, we will be using Rowspan and Colspan attributes. Okay, so this is what the agenda for today, right? So now let us discuss how to code this type of tables. Okay, I'm going to modify my source code. I'm going to make new table like this. Okay, this table I'm going to change like this. So let me explain you how to code like this. Okay, now as you see here, there is time, right? So time is one extra row. Previously we had only 6 rows, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Similarly, in this table also we are having only 6 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. But in extra row we are having time. Okay, so this be considered as extra row. Okay, so totally 7 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Already we coded for 6 rows. Now there is one more row, right? So one more row at the top. So what we need to do is that we need to open one more TR tag. TR stands for table row. Okay, TR stands for table row. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to open one more TR tag at the top, because we need to code time at the top, right? So I'm opening one more TR tag here. Okay, I'm opening one more TR tag here. Now I'm opening. So what content is there in the first row? Days and time, right? Days and time. These two things are of type heading. These two things are not data. Okay, so we cannot use TD tag here. We need to use TH tag. TH stands for table heading. Okay, so we need to use TH tag. Okay, so I'm going to open TH tag. Okay, TH tag. Okay, two times, because I need to code base and time, right? So TH tag. Okay, so here I'm in first TH tag, I'm coding the content as days. In second TH tag, I'm coding the content as time. Okay, now here you can see time covers How many columns? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But as of now, we didn't have morning break, lunch break, and evening break. These columns we don't have here. Okay. So now you consider time column. Time covers this time row. This row covers how many columns? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. This time covers 6 columns. Okay. So what I'm going to do is that, okay, this time covers 6 columns, right? So I'm going to use Colspan attribute here. Okay, Colspan. Okay, so I will explain what is the purpose of Colspan. So I'm going to give the value as 6. Okay, I'm going to give the value as 6. Okay, similarly, days. Here, days, this particular heading covers 2 rows, right? This particular heading covers 2 rows. This row and this row. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to use Rowspan attribute here. Okay, I'm going to use Rowspan attribute. I'm going to specify the value as 2. Okay, now let me explain what is the purpose of Rowspan and Colspan. Okay, Rowspan. Okay, Rowspan in the sense it will instruct our system or it will instruct our computer to cover up to 2 rows. Okay, to cover up to 2 rows. Similarly, Colspan. Colspan will instruct our computer to cover up to 6 columns. Okay, it depends on value. If you are specifying value as 2, this Rowspan will instruct our computer to cover up to 2 rows. Similarly, if you specify here, I am specifying value as 6. So this Colspan, this instruction, okay, we'll instruct our computer to cover up to 6 columns. Okay, so Rowspan and Colspan are mainly used to expanding the rows and expanding the columns. Or we can say covering many rows, covering more than one rows, covering more than one columns. So this is what the main functionality of Rowspan and Colspan. Okay, now here this content days will cover up to 2 rows. Similarly, this content time will cover up to 6 columns. So this is what the concept over here. Now let me save it and let me show you in the web browser. The table will be messy. Let me show you. See, the table is messy. Why? See, here we are using this time, right? Here we are coding this time. So to code time, as you can see here, time covers up to 6 columns, right? Do we add any extra columns in the further rows? No, right? Do we add any extra columns in the further rows? No. Similarly, here, days covering up to 2 rows. Okay, days covering up to 2 rows. Here, there is one extra column. That's why it's displaying like this. Okay, see. If I remove this particular thing, control S, now you can see this. Now it is correct, right? Now it is displaying correctly, right? Why it's displaying messy in the sense, why is the displaying, why previously it's displaying like this? Because here we are having extra row, or we can say extra cell. Okay, here we are having one extra column. Sorry, not row, column. Here we are having an extra column, or we can say extra cell. That's why it is displaying like this. Okay, so we need to check if there are some extra columns or if there are some extra cells, you need to remove it. See, in this table, this cell is empty, right? This cell is empty. Here we are covering 2 cells by days, right? So we need to remove this extra cell. If there is extra cell, finally table here will get collapsed. Okay, so you need you try to code by your own. If table is collapsed, you find why table is collapsed. You need to find and you need to delete that extra cells. Okay, so this is what the content over here. Okay, now so far we completed this days and time. So far we coded like this. Now what we need to do? We need to code morning break, lunch break, and evening break in between. So where is morning break? So morning break is 10:45 to 11 a.m. Lunch break is 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Evening break is 3 p.m. to 3:15 p.m. Right? So see our source code. This is what our source code, right? So in source code, we are having 8:45 to 9:45 a.m., 9:45 to 10:45 a.m., but there is no 10:45 to 11 a.m., right? So let me add 10:45 to 11 a.m. here, okay? By using th tag. Th stands for table heading. So 10:45 a.m. to 11 a.m. Let me close it over here, okay? Next, 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Next, 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Next, 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. is not there, right? So let me code it first here. Okay. 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Okay. Next, 3 p.m. to 3:15 p.m. So let me code it over here. 3 p.m. to 3:15 p.m. Let me close it. Now let me save it, control S. Let me show you in my browser. See, table is messy, okay? Why? Because, see, we didn't include morning break, lunch break, evening break, okay? So here we didn't specify space. Either we need to specify space or we need to specify this data. So let me code it correctly, you can understand, okay? Now, here 10:45 a.m. to 11 a.m. So in 10:45 a.m. to 11 a.m. that is morning break, right? So what I'm going to do is that, see, this is Monday, okay? So in Monday, that means in second row, okay, for this example, this is third row, right? In third row, third shell, okay, fourth shell, 1, 2, 3, 4. In third row, fourth shell is allocated to morning break. Similarly, for fourth row, fourth shell is allocated to morning break. Similarly, for all rows, fourth shell is allocated to morning break, right? So here, fourth shell is allocated to morning break. So let me code it over here. 1, 2, 3, fourth shell is allocated to morning break, right? So I'm going to code here. So this is heading, okay? Morning break is type heading, not data, okay? So let me use th tag, okay, th tag. Okay, let me code morning break. Let me close it over here. Okay, morning break. Now you can see I coded only for this third row. Okay, so morning break is common to all rows 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? So what I'm going to do is that morning break should be spanned to, morning break should cover up to how many rows? Morning break should cover up to 5 rows. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, right? So morning break should cover up to 5 rows. Okay, so what I'm going to do is that I'm going to use Rowspan attribute over here. Rowspan attribute, let me give 5, okay? So by seeing this, so as I said, attributes exist as name value pair, right? So by seeing this, our system will identify, or our system will understand, okay, this particular morning break should cover up to 5 rows, okay? Should cover up to 5 rows. This content should cover up to 5 rows. This is what the interior meaning over here, okay? Now let me do it for other things also. So lunch break is which shell? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th shell, right? Okay, 7th shell, right? So let me do it for this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th shell should be lunch break, right? So let me open th tag. This is also of heading type. So let me open th tag. Let me close it over here. Okay, let me close it over here. So content is lunch break. So what is the content? Lunch break. So this lunch break should be covered up to 5 rows, right? So I'm using Rowspan attribute. If you want to cover columns, you can use Colspan attribute. If you want to cover rows, you can use Rowspan attribute. So Rowspan is 5. Okay. Similarly, let me code it one more thing also. Evening break. 3:02, 3:15, evening break, right? So which shall 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9th shell, right? So let me code it in 9th shell. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let me code it in 9th shell. Okay. PH. Okay. So what is the content? Evening break, right? So evening break. Let me close it over here. So here also, this evening break should cover up to 5 rows, right? So let me open Rowspan attribute. Let me include Rowspan attribute. I'm giving value as 5 because it should cover up to 5 rows. Let me save it. Control S. Now let me reload my browser. You can see. Okay. Now here one more mistake is there. See here. Time is dedicated to all columns. Here now columns increased. Columns are increased, right? So here we are giving Colspan value as 6. Now here you can see columns are increased. So here time covers up to only 6 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Here there are 9 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So to cover time up to 9 columns, I'm giving the value as 9. Okay, let me save it. Control S. Okay, so let me show you now. This is what the exact table, right? This is what the exact table. Please don't panic. Tables concept is so easy. If you know this basic table, if you know how to code this basic table, by modifying this basic table, we can code this. Okay, you try to modify some way. Okay, if you modify this table, you can get this table. Okay, to code this type of table, you need to know two things, Rowspan and Colspan attributes. Okay, the main purpose of Rowspan attribute is it will cover up to many rows, okay, depending upon the value. Okay, similarly, Colspan, it will cover up to many columns depending upon the value. So, this is what the main purpose of Rowspan and Colspan attributes. So if you know the concept of Rowspan and Colspan attribute, you can code this table easily. No worries. Okay. So if you get some structure messy, like messy appearance, if you didn't get the table structure properly, you check if there is any extra cells. If there is any extra cells, if there are some extra cells, you remove that extra cells. If cells are insufficient, you add some cells. Okay, so by modifying like this, you can code this type of table also. Okay, no worries. In next video also, we are going to discuss the table concept. We are going to discuss some more tags in tables, and we are going to see some deprecated attributes in tables. Okay, so these things we'll be discussing in next video. So in next video also, we are going to discuss about tables only. So hope you can get today's concept. Okay, so first of all, you need to know how to code this type of simple tables. If you know to code this type of simple tables, this table is no matter. We can code easily only with the concept of Rowspan and Colspan. If you know Rowspan and Colspan, then you can code this type of tables easily. Okay, so Rowspan will cover up to many rows. Okay, Colspan will cover up to many columns. Okay, here this is the attribute. Okay, Rowspan equal to 2. Rowspan is the name of the attribute, 2 is the value of the attribute. Here this Rowspan tells us here this particular content days will cover up to 2 rows. You can see days covering 2 rows. Similarly, time here this particular content will cover up to 9 columns. You can see it covers 9 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay. So this is what the main purpose of Rowspan and Colspan attribute. It will span up to many rows or many columns. Here it will span up to 2 rows. Here it will span up to 9 columns. Here it will span up to 5 rows. Here also it will span up to 5 rows. Here also similarly it will span up to 5 rows. So this is what the main purpose of Rowspan and Colspan attributes. If you know this concept, then you can code any type of tables in HTML. Okay, so this is how we need to code tabular data in HTML. Okay, so hope you can get my point. Okay, so I hope I completed my agenda. We have seen how to code tabular data in HTML web page. Similarly, we have seen table tag. If you want to code tabular data, you need to enclose every content inside the table tag, because table tag instructs the computer this data is of table type. Okay, so inside that we will be having tr tag. TR stands for table row. So TR instructs the computer this content is of table row. Okay, this content will be there in row. Okay, for example TR, this content is in a particular row. Okay, this is what the meaning of TR. Similarly, TD stands for table data. If you want to represent a data in table, you will be using TD tag. Similarly, TH stands for table heading. If you want to represent any heading in table, we will be using TH tag. So this is what the main concept behind tabular data. So finally, to code these type of tables, we'll be using Rowspan and Colspan attributes. So I hope I completed my agenda today. So in next video, we'll be discussing more concepts about tables, and we will be coding one exercise regarding tables. So in that exercise, we'll be solving exercise for these stuffs also. That's all for today's video. I hope I completed my content today. Thank you for your patience listening. So if this video is useful to you, kindly hit the like button. If this video is useful to you, subscribe my channel and click the bell icon. Share this video to your friends and relatives, those who are interested in learning HTML or those who wanted to become a web developer. Okay, thank you so much for your patience listening. If you feel any difficulties, or if you have any suggestions, you can ping me in the comment section, or you can mail me personally. My mail ID is in the description box. Okay, so thank you so much for your patience listening. It's time to wind up. Thank you so much. Let me wind up my session. See you all in my next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.